Hey guys, Carissa Rose here. All right guys, today it's about to go down. We're doing a battle between cheap and expensive watercolors. So I've been painting with watercolors for a little bit over 5 years, maybe around six. And I've always used Pring Brand watercolors, which is these guys here. It's a 16 color set. They run around $10 at Hobby Lobby. And you can get them for as low as $6 if you use the 40% off coupon they normally offer there. They aren't the cheapest brand ever, but they are pretty cheap, and any artist can pretty much afford them. So that will be the cheap brand I will be using in this comparison. And for the expensive brand that I will be using in this test, it is a Winsor & Newton, the compact travel set. These were the most expensive watercolors I could find that were in a palette with the pans. There was liquid watercolor that was more expensive, but I don't have any experience with those yet. So I figured for this test, I would just stick to the pans and see what would come out better. This set ran me $35 at Hobby Lobby, which is 3.5 times more than the Prangs cost. So let's see if 3.5 times the price really makes 3.5 times the difference. Is it worth it to shell out that extra dough? Let's find out. So for this test, I decided to draw out two different 5x7 pictures that I could paint in. I decided to do one face and then split it up into two separate paintings so I could get them pretty close to each other so I could do a really good comparison. I didn't paint the exact same picture on both sides, but I did try to use all the colors on both sides to get a good comparison. So let's see, can you guess which side was done with Prang and which side was done with Winsor & Newton? You can pause the video and take a look at it, take a second to think. Okay, you got your guess in mind. Let's get started painting. Okay, so we're moving pretty fast here, around 100 times speed. I will be posting videos focusing just on the painting process of these pieces in the future, so be sure to check back for that. But since this video is for the comparison, I just wanted to, speed it up and show you. Here's me going in with the Winsor & Newtons. Also, the black you see in the picture is Sharpie pens and Sharpie markers, and I also will be using white acrylic paint to add highlights later in the painting, just to differentiate that from the watercolors. So here are a couple of the major things I noticed that were big differences between the two brands. First off, the Winsor & Newton set did not come with a black pan. Prang does come with black. A lot of people say you aren't really supposed to use black in watercolors. I say you can do whatever you want. But just keep that in mind, it doesn't come with black. However, I noticed that you can purchase more colors from their website. The next thing I noticed is that you can tell the colors are super pigmented in the pans. Right when you put water to them, you can feel the pigmentation, as weird as that sounds. But you can definitely tell the difference in the pigmentation. You can also tell that the Winsor & Newton watercolors are much more matte than the Prangs. Even just looking at the pans, the Winsor & Newtons are not reflective at all. The Prangs are super reflective when you look at them. As far as how they feel on the paper, oh, and by the way, I used Canson watercolor paper, and that was 140-pound watercolor paper from a watercolor pad. So the Winsor & Newtons stayed wet a lot longer, it seemed like. They didn't dry as quickly as the Prangs did, which is good for some artists. Other artists like to work quicker. If you have to wait for it to dry, you're gonna have to sit around longer. So it depends on your personal style, which you would prefer, but it does make it a lot easier for blending and whatnot while the paper is still wet. And the other major difference I noticed is that once the paints have actually fully dried, the Winsor & Newtons stay down better if you go back over them again with more watercolor. They don't get picked back up as much as the Prangs do. So here's the Winsor & Newton side all finished, and now we're moving on to the Prangs. And I'll show you a side-by-side after this one is done. So as I said earlier, I have a ton of experience with prangs, so I can pull them off pretty well as far as shading goes. But there are a couple downsides to them compared to the Winsor & Newton's after trying them both. One of the main things is that even after they've dried completely, they can still get picked back up with wet water, which may be a downside for some people. For me, I've actually used this to my advantage sometimes, so I guess it depends on your experience level with the paint. Another downside I noticed is that for some reason, the prang watercolors seem to tear up the paper a little bit more when you use more water with them. Maybe it's because you have to use more water, I'm not sure, but it did warp the paper a little bit more violently than the Winsor & Newton's did. And another issue is the consistency of the pigments. With the Winsor & Newton paints, they were super consistent, all the colors felt the same regardless of what color you were using. With the prang watercolors, certain colors don't work as well. The dark blue is a lot harder to work with, the green's a lot harder to work with, whereas the lighter colors like yellow and light green go on so smoothly and easily. So the consistency is definitely an issue. But again, with practice, that's something that can be figured out. But as far as color vibrancy goes, they're both super bright brands. Prang especially is super bright, but Winsor & Newton held up really well next to it. I was worried they wouldn't be as bright just because, you know, Prang's more of like kids' colors, just really vibrant, but yeah, they both held their own when it came to vibrancy. And the one final difference I can think of as far as working with them goes is when you try to go over Winsor & Newton's with Sharpie pens and markers, it does not work well. The colors are so waxy, the pigments are so thick. With Prang, I have no problem going back over them with Sharpie markers and pens. I'm not sure if other mediums or inks or pens would work better going over the Winsor & Newton's. I just use Sharpie pens and markers for most of my outlining work. So for me, the Winsor & Newton's are really tough to go back over. So here is the Prang side all finished. Okay, so here we are. All right, right away, you can see a little bit of differences. You can see that the only thing reflective on the Winsor & Newton is the eyelashes up there. You can see that's reflective. That's because that's where I put the Sharpie over it. But otherwise, there's not really any reflection, really matte. Now, with the Prang, there's a lot of more reflection going on. Any of the colors that are really dark, you can see they get glistened by the light in the eye and in the hair, you can see that. So when I put them together side by side, scanned in the computer, and I posted on Facebook and Instagram a comparison, I wanted to see what people thought, if they could guess which was which, and it was about 50-50. People were mixing up the expensive with the cheap one. So for a final scanned in piece, it was pretty hard to tell the difference. So here's how that came out again. But when it comes to the actual physical original painting, you can see the difference in the quality. So, in conclusion, if you don't want to splurge on that really expensive paint, Prang will get the job done. But if you really want your final painting to be top quality, you're going to have to go the more expensive route. Spend a little bit more, but end up with some really great results because of it. But in the end, it doesn't really matter what paint you use. What matters is that you practice and work hard, and you can make any paint work for you. Okay, guys, so that's my video. I hope that it offered some enlightenment about whether cheap or expensive paint is better. And if you like these paintings, I do have print sets of these pieces available in my Etsy store, and I will have the link to that in the description of the video. What's your favorite brand of watercolors? How about you let me know in the comments, and be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the video. And if you're interested, you can check out my YouTube channel for more drawing and painting videos. Okie dokie. Well, thanks again, guys, and I hope you have a really great day, and toodles.